الله أكبر الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على خير خلقك وأفضل رسلك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وزوجاته أمهات المؤمنين، اللهم وعلى صحابته الغر الميامين، اللهم والتابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، شهر رمضان المبارك knocking our doors and coming, and the doors of the Jannah opens, all the gates of the Jannah opens in this great month, and the call for the goodness and good deeds to every single person is coming. The gate of Ar-Rayyan is open only for those people who observe the fasting and do good deeds in the month of Ramadan, and only for them. And they will enter the heaven from that gate. The month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they choose every night certain number of people and grant them positions in paradise. These great blessings make us to think and really feel very emotional and excited about the coming of the month of Ramadan. Excited indeed, because الأجر والجزاء على قدر المشقة والعمل. The reward will be great as the sacrifice. The fasting longer hours, the reward is longer. The sacrifice more, the reward more. Brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rahimun bi'ibadi. Some areas in the world, they have shorter days, but maybe more hot and more dry. Some other areas may be longer hours, but the day is nicer and cooler and easier. Brothers in Islam, it is from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sometimes we feel this is longer hours in summer, but shorter hours in winter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to experience both. For His sake, for His love, and for the submission of His will. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to have a special journey and special experience in the month of Ramadan. And this is the topic of this khutbah. What we want to gain from Ramadan. What we want to gain from Ramadan. And this is a question that we have to ask ourselves before we enter Ramadan. Otherwise, it will not be in our minds and hearts. It will not be part of our planning and timetable. But if we timetable Ramadan properly, based on this question, what we want to gain from Ramadan, what our objectives, apart from making the fard of fasting and obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and gaining the reward, which is very great. But in personal level and family level and community level, what we want to give, Meaning, after Ramadan, what are the changes that will be in our life that will stay with us? This question should be before Ramadan, not at the end of Ramadan. Because if it is before Ramadan, we will plan it and we will experience it and feel it and struggle doing it during the month of Ramadan. Brothers in Islam, التغيير الذاتي, the self change, is very important in the month of Ramadan. That everyone knows his weaknesses or her weaknesses. And in the month of Ramadan, we should focus how to strengthen ourselves and try to deal with these major issues that always in our life. And every individual has his own story and own weaknesses and own experience. And every one of us knows what the wrong things and what always goes wrong with him or her. And this is actually the focus, because the month of Ramadan is the month of Rahmah, the mercy. The month of Maghfirah, the month of forgiveness. The month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help people and strengthen them. But we need first to identify our weaknesses and have the intention to really do this change. Leave our bad habits and give up our wrongdoings. This intention itself is the first great step toward the solution. As individuals or families or communities. Brothers in Islam, because as it was mentioned, the mercy will be taken if there are sins committed. And the rahmah will come when the sins are lifted. So if we leave our sins and we focus on these weaknesses and rectify our sins and make tawbah, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely. So in the month of Ramadan, we have a checklist. And always we tick these boxes. But at the same time, we have another list and we make sure that we do not go there. We do not go there. We distance ourselves. And this is the journey. By the end of Ramadan, if somebody give up something for 30 days, full month, that will help the person after the month of Ramadan to continue giving up this sin. So it's a great golden opportunity for us, brothers in Islam, to make tawbah nasuha. Tawbah nasuha means that the person will not go back at all after that. He has the strength, he has the intention, he has the azimah, the will, power, self-esteem, not to go back. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help this person who give up, who regret from the heart, who regret from the heart all the past and all the bad doings that he did before. And he create environment. He create environment, a new environment, so he can change. Because if the person stay with the same environment and associate himself or herself with the sin, other factors that always associated with the sin, then the person will not progress. The person need to move forward and change that environment and these factors. So really change will happen. Brothers in Islam, the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, even they used to change the clothes that they commit the sin in and not come back to them again. Or the places or people that were associated with that sin. To that extent, yes. Because creating a new environment that will help the person to start a new chapter. Brothers in Islam, this is a great month of Ramadan. We know it is the month of Al-Akhlaq, the month of Al-Akhlaq, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it is the heaviest thing in the scale of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have good morals and good manners. And there's no one perfect. Everyone has certain things. Somebody has temper, somebody is impatient, somebody this, somebody that. Everyone has his own thing. But if you work hard, because fasting is not really abstaining from food and drink. That is the symbolic thing, that physical thing that we do. But indeed, it is for us to abstain from the bad doings and the bad deeds and bad words and control our desires and our behaviors and actions. And that will make the change, brothers in Islam. If we as individuals work on ourselves sincerely, then we make a change in our families and our communities. Then there will be change in the Muslim Ummah. Brothers in Islam, our tongue needs to fast. Our eyes needs to fast. Our ears needs to fast. Our bodies needs to fast, not only stomach. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the main core issue of the fasting is really to abstain from the bad words and bad deeds, and not really only the food and the drink. And that is not really the main purpose, but the main purpose is the change that we should do. Second point, brothers in Islam, I want to share with you. Because the good deeds in Ramadan, after we talked about the really change and the list that we really want to be honest with ourselves and say we are going to stop these things and we are going to stop this attitude or these ideas or these feelings towards certain things or the behaviors or these words that we use and they are harmful to our iman and deen and family members and community and the whole Muslim Ummah. The second thing, brothers in Islam, because the good deeds are too many and vary in the month of Ramadan. And we know all these, the Quran, the Sadaqah, and the Taraweeh, listening to the Quran, reading the Quran, and feeding the fasting people, looking after the family, all these kind of things that we do in the month of Ramadan. We should categorize them in two categories. If we look at the Hayat al-Sahaba radiallahu anhu, the life of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, and if we see what their focus was in Ramadan, we will find two things where they focus in Ramadan. The first focus is the Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The Quran, listening, reading, tilawa, understanding, hifz, revision, memorizing, قيام الليل, تراويح, تهجد, all comes with the Quran. They end it with dhikr, with dua. This is all one category. The Quran and dhikr and the dua and the nawafil and tahajjud. Spiritual, great relation between the person and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Understanding the Quran, he used to read the tafsir and talk about the tafsir and learn the tafsir, brothers in Islam. Part of it, Laylatul Qadr, because this is one of the great qiyam and tahajjud and thawab. And we are lucky we should have this intention to have i'tikaf in the last 10 days of Ramadan, at least at night, because it is only 2.5 hours. 2.5 hours will be left after Taraweeh, between Taraweeh and Fajr, or almost 2 hours, if you want to take half an hour for Suhoor. Brothers in Islam, but that will gain the reward, the person of 1,000 months of Ibadah. The second category, brothers in Islam, in the month of Ramadan, is As-Sadaqah. As-Sadaqah. Wal-Ihsan. Starting, of course, from the Zakah, which is an obligation that many people, they do pay their Zakah during the month of Ramadan, tabarrukan bi Ramadan. And this is very important, to pay the zakah as soon as possible, because this is the rights of the poor and needy. An obligation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it on us, so we can share the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, in the month of Ramadan, we need also to do optional sadaqat, donations, and pay to the charity, to the needy, to the orphans, to the widows, to the masakin, to the aitam, to the families of shaheeds, families of prisoners, families of those people who are not working because they are ill or unable to work. Brothers in Islam, being nice to our families and relatives, All this comes under this category. As-sadaqa wal-ihsan. Donating to the masajid, maintaining and building the masajid is part of the sadaqat. Iftar al-sa'imim, to feed those one who fasted during the day of Ramadan, it comes under the category of sadaqah. So if we look at the whole a'mal, deeds that the Sahaba radiallahu anhu used to focus, we will find these two categories, big categories. The Quran and the prayers and dua and tahajjud and qiyam and nawafil, that's one category. And the second category is as-sadaqat. As-sadaqat wal-ihsan, the kindness to others. That's why they say it'amu ta'am wa qira'atul Quran in the month of Ramadan. Brothers in Islam, this is very, very important. We start with our families. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, feeding your wife is sadaqah. Feeding your children is sadaqah. Feeding even yourself is sadaqah. If you have the niyyah, the intention to do so, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bringing the happiness into the family in the month of Ramadan is very important. Looking after the family is very important. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَبْدَأْ بِمَا تَعُولُ. When you want to start your kindness, start with those people under your responsibility. Because we cannot be kind to others and not kind to our own families. Brothers in Islam, أَفْضَلُ الصَّدَقَةَ مَا كَانَتْ. Also as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَأَنْتَ صَحِيحٌ شَحِيحٌ. When the person is rich, when the person has something, he's healthy, he can donate. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تَأْمَنْ الْغِنَى وَتَخْشَى الْفَقْرِ. When you are worried from the poverty, we are worried from the decrease, and you are always hoping the increase, and always earning and bringing more, this is the time for you to really, and this is the opportunity for you to donate. Not when it is too late, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the same hadith, وَلَا تَهْمِلْ وَتَمْهِلْ حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُوْ. Do not wait until last moment in your life when the soul reached the throat. And then after that you say, this is for this person and that for that person. And you start to distribute your inheritance. The Prophet ﷺ said, the opportunity is when we are healthy and wealthy. We should donate and help and be kind and generous. Not wait until the last moment. When we are alive, we should show our kindness and generosity, not just before our death. Brothers in Islam, أفضل الصدقة على ذي الرحم كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. That the best sadaqah is within your relatives. You start with your relatives. We do it for all over the world because all our Muslim ummah are our relatives. Our Muslim ummah, they are our relatives. But also we need to look after our cousins, our uncles, our aunties, make sure also they are fine. This is why in Ramadan we should distribute our sadaqat. We should give some of these sadaqat to our relatives. We should give some sadaqat locally for local great deeds. And also we should give some of our sadaqat internationally for those people who are suffering in areas of conflicts and wars and fitna. Lots of innocent people, they are not part of the conflict, but they are paying the price of conflict. They are victims and they need our help. Brothers in Islam, this is Ramadan. This is indeed Ramadan for the Muslims. It's Quran and Sadaqat wa Ihsan. And this is Ramadan. A change from inside and great tawbah, seeking the maghfirah and the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and looking after people. Looking after people. We are not living for ourselves indeed. And this is our understanding of Islam. But indeed we are living for people around us. And for the Muslim ummah. Because we have the mission. And we have the great message of Islam to pass to the Muslim ummah and to the world. Brothers in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at this great hadith. He said, أفضل الأعمال أن تدخل على أخيك سرورا أو تقضي عنه دينا أو تطعمه خبزا. The best deed that you can do is to bring the happiness into your brother or sister. To remove a difficulty, to pay, to clear their debt, or to feed them when they need piece of bread. Brothers in Islam, some of the areas in the world, 1 or 2 pounds will be enough to feed a person in the month of Ramadan for their iftar. And less than that for their suhoor. And this is a great also motivation for even the students, for even those one who are not earning that much, for those one who are hardly managing their expenses, to donate even little for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah, as He said, and the Quran said, and the Hadith said, that if the person donate, Allah will bless him with more and more. مَا نَقَصَ مَالٌ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people who do really change within themselves and make Ramadan for us a change journey and discovery journey, and grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, holding the Quran and experiencing a great experience with the Quran in the month of Ramadan, and make ihsan and sadaqat and kindness to others. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people of rahmah and maghfirah and idq min al-nar and jannat al-firdaus al-a'la ya rabbal alameen. Aqulu ma tisma'una wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fa ya fawza al-mustaghfirin. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد. أيها الإخوة، النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يسد خاب وخسر من أدركه رمضان ولم يغفر له. He said the real loser is the one when he experienced the month of Ramadan, he doesn't gain the maghfirah, the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are not doing it for diet reason. Indeed, it's very healthy and good for our health and stomach. We are not doing it for any reason except for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what we really need, the maghfirah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is our key success. And then the Prophet ﷺ said in that hadith, also the real loser is the one that he has one or both of his parents old in his lifetime and he is not kind to them. That is also very big loss, because our Islam is not to do only ibadat but also mu'amalat, also kindness, also good morals. And we have to start with our parents, because they are the reason of our creation, because Allah created us through them, and also because they paid all their life for us. All the illnesses that they gain when they are old, because the effort and hard work that they did in their life for us. They didn't enjoy many things for our sake, to be grown and looked after, to be educated. And then when we gain the strength and education and health and wealth and everything, we have to pay everything back to them, and we will never do. We cannot pay them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to a man who is carrying his mother in the Hajj time and the Tawaf, and when he was asked, is this enough? Is this considered that I paid her what she did for me when I was young? And he said, even you didn't pay one single push when she delivered you. Brothers in Islam, our parents went through very difficult times to look after us and to make us reach this stage in our life. If they are alive, we need to be kind and good to them. We need to look after them. If they are ill, we need to be around them. We should not leave them in the hospital alone or dying alone. Because the best thing for a person to die with his family around him. We should not leave them struggling their expenses and their bills. And while we are alive, brothers in Islam, our parents, our key success, and indeed, the secret of the success of the Muslim is how much kind this person to his parents, and how much he close this person to his parents. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with those people that their parents pleased with them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not have mercy on those people that their parents are not pleased with them. And if they are not alive, we need to make dua for them. Make dua sincerely after or during each prayer for them, for all what they did for us. And brothers in Islam, we need to make umrah for them, make hajj for them, make sadaqah, charities on their behalf, so they can gain higher ranks in paradise. Because this is their right from us. And this is our duty and responsibility toward them, our parents. We are nothing without them and without being kind to them. And brothers, let's pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather all of us with our parents in Jannat al-Firdaus. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidun Majid. Allahumma a'inna ala anfusina bifi'l at-ta'at وترك المنكرات. اللهم احينا مسلمين وتوفنا مسلمين والحقنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه من العمل الصالح. اللهم بارك لنا فيما تبقى من شعبان وبلغنا رمضان واجعلنا من اهل الصيام والقيام وقراءه القران. اللهم زك نفوسنا انت خير من زكاها. اللهم اتها تقواها يا رب العالمين. اللهم انا نسالك باسمك الاعظم وجدك الاعلى وكلماتك التامات لوالدينا جنه الفردوس الاعلى يا رب العالمين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. اللهم من كان منهم حيا اللهم اطل في عمره. اللهم واحسن عمله واحسن ختامه. اللهم ومن كان منهم ميتا اللهم اجمعنا بهم في جناتك جنات الاعلى يا رب العالمين. اللهم انا نسالك يا ربنا باسمك الاعظم وجدك الاعلى وكلماتك التامات يا رب السماوات والارض يا نور السماوات والارض يا قيوم السماوات والارض لاخواننا المستضعفين ان تكون لهم عونا ومعينا. اللهم انزل سكنتك ورحمتك عليهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن معهم يا الله. اللهم يسر عليهم امرهم في رمضان. اللهم يسر امرهم في رمضان. اللهم اكرمهم يا رب العالمين في كل مكان. اللهم وحد المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم اجمع شوكة المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم الطف بالمسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم ارحم أمة المرحوم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم ارحم هذه الأمة المرحومة يا الله. اللهم ارحمها يا الله. اللهم اكرمها يا الله. اللهم ارزقها الإحسان والخير. اللهم ارزقها الرحمة والمغفرة والتواصل والتسامح والعفو يا رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على خير خلقك وأفضل رسلك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وزوجاته أمهات المؤمنين على أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وجميع صحابة نبيك أجمعين والتابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين والحمد لله رب العالمين.